I can hear you say that I'm the one. At times I feel your lips press close to mine, but what good has that dreaming done?
Welcome to the Antique Music Mall. This is show number 47, and my name is Phil. And to tell you the truth, this was not supposed to be my show. Brooke Palmer was supposed to take this one. You know, Brooke Palmer is in another country across the ocean, but we still have a set time, and I still monitor everything she does. But when she's not there, it really throws a monkey wrench in everything we do, and it's starting to bother me a little bit. But anyway, we will go on with the show. This show is going to be so easy to solve, it's almost insulting. But still, I like the songs, I like the music, and I like the whole theme of it, even though it's an easy theme. And you'll see what I mean very quickly, and you'll probably get this in one or two songs. But that's okay. And a lot of these songs, because of this particular common thread, have a southern flavor. A lot of country kinds of songs. Most of them do cross over to the pop chart. So let's just go ahead and get started. Here comes the first one. I question myself about using this first song for our podcast. We are, after all, a family show. But we are going to present the G narrative for this song. It's called LaGrange. The song is actually about the chicken ranch, sometimes called Miss Edna's Boarding House, which was a long-established business catering to the oldest profession. It was closed down by a zealous TV reporter who couldn't find enough vice and corruption to report in his own city. The governor had no choice but to order the sheriff to close it. The place in this song is the subject of a 1982 movie starring Dolly Parton and Burt Reynolds, which was adapted from a 1978 Broadway play. This song was written by Frank Beard, Billy Gibbons, and Dusty Hill. ZZ Top just missed making this a top 40 hit. It peaked at number 41. And this song is a Rock and Roll Hall of Fame record, and it came out in 1974.
Rumors spreading round in that Texas town about the shack outside the game. You know what I'm talking about. Just let me know if you wanna go to that whole mile on the range. They got a lot of nice girls. I'm racing. I'm all
Austin Prison is a song written by Johnny Cash and originally recorded by him on Columbia Records for his novelty album Everybody Loves a Nut. It was first released in May 1966 as the flip side of the single also entitled Everybody Loves a Nut. Although Cash cultivated a romantic outlaw image, he never served a prison sentence. Despite landing in jail 7 times for misdemeanors, he stayed only one night on each stay. On May 11, 1965, he was arrested in Starkville, Mississippi for trespassing late at night onto private property to pick flowers. But I don't think he was ever locked up in Austin Prison.
They had a warrant out for me all over the country, and I was trying to beat 2 raps in Idaho. I was breaking into a schoolhouse Sunday morning without warning, when I saw the sheriff coming for me slow from down below. His steel gray eyes were blazing when he saw me. His hand was on his gun when he rolled up. Said you killed that woman, I know you shot her, why'd you do it? I'm taking you to Austin and I'm gonna lock you up. Well, he tied me with a plow line the next morning, and he had me deep in Texas the next day. A crazy screaming lynch mob waited in the streets of Austin, but he put me in the jailhouse and he threw the key away. A jury found me guilty 3 months later, 12 evil men with murder in their eyes. They even took me out and said, now show us where you killed her. And that wicked judge said, now I hereby sentence you to die. But here I am far away from Austin Prison. My friend the jailer handed me a file. Now all I want between me and there are a lot of friendly people, and miles and miles and miles and miles and miles and miles and miles.
This third song was written by songwriter Jimmy Webb, who also wrote By the Time I Get to Phoenix and Wichita Lineman for Glen Campbell. And this next song is Galveston. Not many people know that in 1968, Hawaiian singer Don Ho was the first person to record Galveston, releasing it as the B-side of his single, Has Anybody Lost a Love? Don Ho recalled that when he appeared on the Glen Campbell Good Time Hour in 1969, he gave his host a copy of the single and told him, I didn't have any luck with this, maybe you will. According to Rolling Stone magazine, within a year of Glen Campbell's hit version, recordings of Galveston had sold 6 million copies, having been cut by 27 different artists from fellow country star Farron Young to jazz great Dizzy Gillespie. This song peaked at number 4 in the Hot 100, spending 3 months on the chart. It was also a number 1 country hit and a number 1 adult contemporary hit.
Galveston, oh Galveston, I still hear your sea winds blowing. I still see her dark eyes glowing. She was 21 when I left Galveston. Galveston, oh Galveston, I still hear your sea waves crashing. While I watch the cannons flashing, I clean my gun and dream of Galveston. I still see her standing by the water, standing there looking out to sea. And is she waiting there for me on the beach where we used to run? Galveston, oh Galveston, I am so afraid of dying before I dry the tears she's crying, before I watch your seabirds flying in the sun at Galveston, at Galveston.
While Streets of Laredo remains a popular folk standard, the song has garnered even greater fame as the inspiration for the 1993 novel similarly entitled Streets of Laredo, written by Larry McMurtry. The novel, fourth and final in the Lonesome Dove series, is a Western classic following the adventures of Captain Woodrow F. Call. The book was made into a TV series starring James Garner and Sissy Spacek in 1995, further immortalizing the song. Streets of Laredo was also used in Ang Lee's 2005 cowboy movie, Brokeback Mountain. The song itself is widely considered to be a traditional ballad. It was first published in 1910 in John Lomax's Cowboy Songs and Other Frontier Ballads. This tune sometimes had other titles, including Cowboy's Lament. There have been over 600 versions of this song, the first one being credited to Vernon Dalhart in 1927. But next, we're going to play a version from 1963. This is Eddie Arnold.
As I walked out in the streets of Laredo, as I walked out in Laredo one day, I spied a poor cowboy wrapped up in white linen, wrapped up in white linen as cold as the clay. I see by your outfit that you are a cowboy. These words he did say as I boldly stepped by. Come sit down beside me and hear my sad story. I was shot in the breast, and I know I die. Oh, beat the drum slowly and play the fife lowly. Play the dead march as you carry me along. Take me to the green valley. There lay the sod old. go fetch me a cup of cold water to cool my parched lips, the poor cowboy said, before I return. The spirit had left him and gone to its maker. The cowboy was dead. We beat the drum slowly and played the fife lowly and bitterly wept as we bore him along, for we all loved our comrade so brave, young and handsome. We all loved our comrade,
Terry Allen is an independent artist working since 1966 in a wide variety of media, including musical and theatrical performances, sculpture, painting, drawing, and video, and installations which incorporate any and all of these media. Allen began his musical career learning to play piano from his mother, Pauline Pierce Allen, who was a professional piano player. In 1962, while in high school, he wrote his first song, Redbird, which he would go on to perform live on Shindig in 1965. He has recorded 12 albums of original songs, including the landmark releases Juarez in 1975 and Lubbock on Everything from 1979. Rolling Stone magazine describes his catalog, reaching back to Juarez, as uniformly eccentric and uncompromising, savage and beautiful, literate and guttural. And from that 1979 album, we next highlight Lubbock Woman.
She's sitting in the front room, just watching the TV, painting her nails red in black negligee. She just teased up her new wig and painted her eyelids blue. Yeah, she's out to win, but she's destined to lose. Too much rouge, too much booze, too many moving magazines, too many high tones of making fun of her and the way she lives, too many low lights of making her promises. Lonely and raw and raunchy and has a good heart. Yes, she has a good heart. She has a good heart. She has a she has a good heart.
Philip. Why did you start the podcast? I told you that I would be a bit late.
Hello, Brooke. That late thing has been happening more and more recently. I have a schedule to keep.
Please, Philip. Don't act as if you actually have a life. It would not kill you to wait an extra hour. You're retired now. Please stop stressing over this. I was all prepared with my script and insights into these songs.
Good. Then I can leave and you do the rest of the show.
Philip, please don't go away mad. Just go away.
Goodbye, Brooke, and have a good show.
I believe he stormed out of his studio. He's probably more upset that I figured out his theme so easily. Didn't you? Even being from England, I know that all these songs had a Texas city in the title. The first song was LaGrange. LaGrange is a city in Fayette County, Texas, near the Colorado River. LaGrange is in the center of the Texas-German belt. The population was 4,391 at the 2020 census. LaGrange is the county seat of Fayette County. Austin is the state capital of Texas, an inland city bordering the Hill Country region. It is home to the University of Texas flagship campus, and Austin is known for its eclectic live music scene centered around country, blues, and rock. Its many parks and lakes are popular for hiking, biking, swimming, and boating. Galveston is an island city on the Gulf Coast of Texas. It's known for moody gardens, where giant glass pyramids house sharks, monkeys, and other animals. Amusement rides and restaurants line Galveston Island Historic Pleasure Pier, on the south shore. West is bird-rich Galveston Island State Park, with its trails, kayak launches, and fishing spots. Stewart Beach and East Beach are on the island's eastern end. Laredo is a city on the Mexican border, in southern Texas. The Republic of the Rio Grande Museum chronicles the short-lived independent nation, with displays on local culture and history. Next to Los Dos Laredos Park, a bridge crosses the Rio Grande into Mexico. Lake Casablanca International State Park has trails and a fish-filled lake. The Imaginarium of South Texas is a children's museum with hands-on exhibits. Lubbock is a city in northwest Texas, known as the birthplace of rock and roll legend Buddy Holly. The Buddy Holly Center celebrates his life and music with artifacts and mementos. Nearby is the West Texas Walk of Fame, with a statue of Holly and plaques honoring musicians from the region. The Museum of Texas Tech University houses millions of objects of art, history, and paleontology, plus the Moody Planetarium. Houston is a large metropolis in Texas, extending to Galveston Bay. It's closely linked with the Space Center, the Coastal Visitor Center at NASA's Astronaut Training and Flight Control Complex. The city's relatively compact downtown includes the Theater District, home to the renowned Houston Grand Opera, and the Historic District, with 19th-century architecture and upscale restaurants. The song Houston was released by Dean Martin in 1965. It spent 9 weeks in Billboard's pop chart and peaked at number 21. However, the Smooth Dino took this song to number 2 on the Adult Contemporary chart.
Well, it's lonesome in this old town. Everybody puts me down. I'm a face without a name, just walking in the rain, going back to Houston, Houston, Houston. I got holes in both of my shoes while I'm a walking cases of blues. Saw a dollar yesterday, but the wind blew it away, going back to Houston, Houston, Houston. I haven't eaten in about a week. I'm so hungry when I walk, I squeak. Nobody calls me friend. It's sad the shape I'm in, going back to Houston, Houston, Houston. to Houston, Houston, Houston. I got a girl with mail for me. Well, at least she said she'd be. I got a home and a big warm bed and a feather pillow for my head. Going back to Houston, Houston, Houston. Well, it's lonesome in this old town. Everybody puts me down. I'm a face without a name, just walking in the rain. Going back to Houston, Houston, Houston. Going back to Houston, Houston.
San Antonio is a major city in south central Texas with a rich colonial heritage. The Alamo, an 18th century Spanish mission, preserved as a museum, marks the infamous 1836 battle for Texan independence from Mexico. Following the San Antonio River, the miles-long Riverwalk is a landmark pedestrian promenade lined with cafes and shops. Hemisphere Park's 750-foot Tower of the Americas overlooks the city. The song San Antonio Rose goes back to 1938 as a swing instrumental introduced by Bob Wills and his Texas Playboys. It quickly became the band's most popular number. A couple of years later, Mr. Wills and the band members added lyrics, calling it the new San Antonio Rose. And he had another hit with this lyrical version in 1941. But Bing Crosby, Being Bing, had an even bigger hit this same year. Fast forward 20 more years to 1961. We're going to play Patsy Cline's version. Joel Whitburn calls this a classic non-Hot 100 hit.
Deep within my heart lies a melody, a song of old San Antonio, where in dreams I live with a memory beneath the stars all alone. Well, it was there I found beside the Alamo enchantment strange as the blue up above. All that moonlit past that only he would know still hears my broken song of love. Moon in all your splendor, known only to my heart, call back my rose, rose of San Antonio. Lips so sweet and tender, like petals falling apart, speak once again. I know still live in my heart all alone. All that moonlit passed by the Alamo and rose my rose of San Antonio. Song, empty words I know still live in my heart all alone. For that moonlit passed by the Alamo and rose my rose of San Antonio, and rose my rose of San Antonio, and rose my rose of San Antonio.
Marty Robbins wrote El Paso in a car as he and his family were traveling through Texas on the way to Arizona. The song is a Western saga complete with drama, violence, and romance. The singer falls in love with a Mexican girl named Felina, but when he sees her with another man, he shoots the guy, killing him. He steals a horse and makes his escape, but love compels him to return to the scene of the crime, where he is met with a bullet to the chest. I think going back to Felina was an unwise decision. But did you know Marty Robbins also wrote El Paso City, 16 years later? Unlike El Paso, from 1960, this song did not enter Billboard's pop chart, however, it was a classic non-Hot 100 hit. And it was a number one country hit, Mr. Robbins' 15th, on the U.S. country singles chart. Let's hear El Paso City.
From 30,000 feet above the desert floor, I see it there below. A city with a legend, the West Texas city of El Paso. Where long ago I heard a song about a Texas cowboy and a girl. And a little place called Roses where he used to go and watch this beauty world. I don't recall who sang the song, but I recall the story that I heard. And as I look down on the city, I remember each and every word. The singer sang about a jealous cowboy and the way he used a gun to kill another cowboy, then he had to leave El Paso on the run. El Paso City, by the Rio Grande, the cowboy lived and rode away, but love was strong, he couldn't stay. He rode back just to die in that El Paso city. El Paso City, by the Rio Grande, I try not to let you cross my mind, but still I find there's such a mystery in the song that I don't understand. My mind is down there somewhere as I fly above the badlands of New Mexico. I can't explain why I should know the very trail he rode back to El Paso. Can it be that man can disappear from life and live another time? And does the mystery deepen cause you think that you yourself lived in that other time? Somewhere in my deepest thoughts, familiar scenes and memories unfold. These wild and unexplained emotions that I've had so long, but I have never told. Like every time I fly up through the heavens and I see you there below, I get the feeling sometime in another world I live in El Paso. El Paso City, by the Rio Grande. Could it be that I could be the cowboy in this mystery that died there in that desert sand so long ago? El Paso City, by the Rio Grande. A voice tells me to go and see, another voice keeps telling me maybe death awaits me in El Paso. El Paso City.
Amarillo is a city in the Texas Panhandle. It is a gateway to the vast Palo Duro Canyon State Park. The Cadillac Ranch is an installation of graffiti-decorated cars, partly buried in a field. With Art Deco, and Spanish Revival buildings, U.S. Route 66 6th Street Historic District, is a hub for dining and antiques. The American Quarter Horse Hall of Fame and Museum is dedicated to the famous horse breed. And in 1972, English musician, singer and actor, Tony Christie, had his only U.S. pop hit with a song written by Neil Sedaka and Howard Greenfield. Well, sort of. Is This the Way to Amarillo spent 1 week on the pop chart and bubbled under at number 121. But 5 years later, in 1977, Neil Sedaka released his own version of this song, now called Amarillo. It did a bit better, peaking at number 44 and spending 7 weeks on the chart. Is this a brand new oldie for most of you?
When the day is dawning on a Texas Sunday morning, how I long to be there with Marie, who's waiting for me there. Every lonely city where I hang my hat ain't as half as pretty as where my baby's at. Is this the way to Amarillo? Every night I've been hugging my pillow, dreaming dreams of Amarillo and sweet Marie who waits for me. Show me the way to Amarillo. I've been weeping like a willow, crying over Amarillo and sweet Marie who waits for me. A church bell ringing, hear the sound of joy that it's singing for the sweet Maria and the guy who's coming to see her just beyond the highway. Lies an open plain and it keeps me going.
Fort Worth is a city in north-central Texas. In the late 19th century, it became an important trading post for cowboys at the end of the Chisholm Trail. Today, it's a modern city with international art institutions like the Kimball Art Museum. The Fort Worth Stockyards are home to rodeos and the National Cowgirl Museum and Hall of Fame, which honors pioneers. Does Fort Worth ever cross your mind? Is a song written by Sanger Dee and Darlene Schaefer and recorded by American country music artist George Strait. It was released in September 1984 as the lead single and title track from his album of the same name. It reached number one on the country music charts in the United States and number 10 in Canada.
Mm-hmm.
Luckenbach, Texas is an unincorporated community 13 miles from Fredericksburg, in southeastern Gillespie County, Texas. Named for German nobleman Jacob Luckenbach, who helped settle the Texas Hill Country in 1845, Luckenbach is known as a venue for country music and for its German-Texan heritage. Luckenbach's population increased to a high of 492 in 1904, but by the 1960s, it was almost a ghost town. A newspaper advertisement offering town, population 3 for sale led actor Geach Koch and Hondo Crouch, a rancher and Texas folklorist, to buy Luckenbach for $30,000 in 1970. Luckenbach, Texas, Back to the Basics of Love is a song recorded by American country music artist Waylon Jennings. It was released in April 1977 as the first single from the album, Ole Waylon. It was written by Chips Moman and Bobby Emmons. This song spent 4 months in the Hot 100, peaking at number 25. It also reached number 1 on the US Hot Country Songs chart. At the time of recording the song, neither the writers nor Mr. Jennings had ever been to Luckenbach. In his autobiography, Waylon Jennings wrote, "I knew it was a hit song, even though I didn't like it, and still don't." You can hear Willie Nelson's vocal on this track.
The only two things in life that make it worth living is guitars tuned good and firm feeling women. I don't need my name in the marquee lights. I got my song and I got you with me tonight. Maybe it's time we got back to the basics of love. Let's go to Luckenbach, Texas, Waylon and Willie and the boys. This successful life we're living got us feuding like the Hatfields and McCoys. Between
Hank Williams' pain songs and Lou Berry's train songs and blue eyes crying in the rain. Out in Lukenbach, Texas, ain't nobody feeling no pain. So baby, let's sell your diamond ring, buy some boots and faded jeans and go away. This coat and tie is choking me, and in your high society you cry all day. We've been so busy keeping up with the Joneses, four-car garage, and we're still building on. Maybe it's time we got back to the basics of love. Let's go to Lukenbach, Texas, Waylon and Willie and the boys. This successful life we're living got us feuding like the Hatfields and McCoys. Between Hank Williams' pain songs and Newberry's train songs and blue eyes crying in the rain, out in Lukenbach, Texas, ain't nobody feeling no pain.
Let's go to Lukenbach, Texas, Willie and Waylon and boys. This successful life we're living's got us feuding like the Hatfields and the Coys. Between the Hank Williams pain songs, Jerry Jeff train songs and blue eyes crying in the rain. Out in Lukenbach, Texas, there ain't nobody feeling no pain.
Dallas is a modern metropolis in North Texas. It is a commercial and cultural hub of the region. Downtown Sixth Floor Museum at Dealey Plaza commemorates the site of President John F. Kennedy's assassination in 1963. In the Arts District, the Dallas Museum of Art and the Crow Collection of Asian Art exhibits thousands of years of artistry. The Sleek Nasher Sculpture Center showcases contemporary sculpture. Dallas is also a song written by Leona Williams that was originally recorded by American country music singer Connie Smith. Connie Smith was born in 1941 in Elkhart, Indiana. Her contralto vocals have been described by music writers as significant and influential to the women of country music. A similarity has been noted between her vocal style and the stylings of country vocalist Patsy Cline. Dallas was released as a single on Columbia Records in 1974 and reached number 35 on the U.S. Hot Country Songs chart. That same year it was issued on her second studio album entitled That's the Way Love Goes. I am your host, Brooke Palmer. Until next we meet, cheerio.
Dallas, I'll be coming home, it won't be very long. Don't let them close your roads till I get back. My daddy thinks I'm gone for good, but mama, she knows better. Dallas, I'll be coming home to you. You couldn't understand that night why I packed up and left you. You knew I wouldn't find it way out here. These city lights of Tulsa make me lonesome for you, Dallas. Dallas, I'll be coming home to you. Please take care of my baby. Now you know I love him, Dallas. I wouldn't leave him with you.